Hello! In this video, I will explain an example of some interrelationships between our body systems. In a previous video, I mentioned that our body systems work together. Now, in this video, you will see how. First, I will start with a little overview of the integumentary system, because I will use one of its functions in my example. This system forms the external body covering. It separates our inner organs from the external environment and prevents their injury. For example, it protects us from microbes and bacteria. This system has also many other functions, like helping in the regulation of body temperature, eliminating some wastes, helping in the production of vitamin D, and it is the location of cutaneous nerve receptors. But in this example, we will only focus on its function of protecting the body from the external environment. Now, in order to clearly visualize how some of the body systems work together, I will represent our body as a box. Each system I will be using in this example will be part of this box. For example, the integumentary system will be separating the external environment from the inner environment of the box. Next, we have the digestive system. This will be the next system we will be using in the example. This system is composed of the oral cavity, esophagus, stomach, small and large intestines, rectum, and anus. This system breaks down the food that we eat, allowing the absorption of nutrients into the blood. It also eliminates the indigestible material. We will represent this system as a tube. Actually, in reality, it is a long twisting tube. It starts at the oral cavity or the mouth and ends at the anus. Next, we have the respiratory system. It is composed of the lungs and air pathways, which are pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchioles, and alveoli. This system supplies the blood with oxygen and removes carbon dioxide from the body. It also helps in the regulation of acid-base balance. We were represented in the box with the alveoli. Now, I know it is starting to get a little bit confusing, but after the cardiovascular system, you will start seeing how these systems are working together. Now, for the cardiovascular system, it is formed of the heart, the blood, and the blood vessels. The blood pumped by the heart transports oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, and wastes. In addition, it helps regulating the body temperature, acid-base balance, and defends us from disease. Now here we can start seeing how the digestive system, the respiratory system, and the cardiovascular system are completing each other. As we notice, the digestive system is breaking down the food that we eat into nutrients that are then absorbed by the blood. Similarly, the blood is absorbing the oxygen from the respiratory system through the thin walls of the alveolus. Both the nutrients and the oxygen are transported by the blood to the cells that will take the oxygen and the nutrients and give the blood the carbon dioxide and the wastes. The carbon dioxide will then be transported by the blood to the respiratory system. That will eliminate it. Now, for the wastes, they will also be transported by the blood to the urinary system to be eliminated. This system is composed of the kidney, ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra. It has several functions. It maintains acid-base balance, regulates water and electrolytes, red blood cell formation, and the volume of the chemical composition of the blood. Now, what we care about is that the urinary system eliminates nitrogenous wastes after absorbing them from the blood. So this was one example of how our body systems work with each other. There are many other examples that can prove that also. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. And if you have any question, I am more than ready to answer it in the comments. Bye.